Deep in the ancient mountains of the American East, there are some small relics of wilder times. Blue line streams cascade through the landscape, carrying cool, clear, and life-giving water that holds a colorful secret. We now live in a modern world dominated by new technology like artificial intelligence, and it feels as if there is this ever-increasing separation between man and nature. This, however, is a hopeful story of a fish said to be touched by the Great Spirit that endured a dark history and now faces an uncertain future.
Okay. See if you can get a little further up. Yep. Oh, oh, miss. Got it. Got him. Let's go. Oh, it's a pretty one.
If you've seen any of our content over the years, it is no secret that these are our favorite fish. Brook trout are a species of freshwater fish native to eastern North America, and particularly the cold and clear streams and rivers of the Appalachian region. They're arguably most well known for their vibrant and unique colors. We have to agree with author Nick Carass in his iconic book about the species when he says, "Brook trout are the prettiest fish in the world. They carry with them the colors of the great eastern forests in all four seasons. A green marbled back, yellow and red dots, some haloed in blue, with lower fins that are piped in pure white and an underbelly that is brush-stroked in a vibrant orange." These colorful fish aren't all just looks. Brook trout play a crucial role in the ecosystem, serving as both predator and prey, and in many places as a keystone species. They're also what we call an indicator species, which means that they require pristine aquatic habitats, thriving in waters with temperatures generally between 52 and 61 degrees Fahrenheit. And when water conditions don't meet these high standards, brookies just can't survive. And this makes them canaries in the coal mine when it comes to predicting the future health of wild ecosystems. Beneath their striking colors and ecological importance lies a troubling history. Now, most of our fishing for brook trout over the years has been in the Appalachian region, and the eastern brook trout is the only species of the salmon and trout family native to the southern Appalachians. Even though it's been called a trout since its discovery by early European settlers, it is actually a char, and biologists believe that these colorful char first arrived in the southern Appalachians during the Pleistocene era, which began about 1.8 million years ago and ended about 11,000 years ago. According to the Seneca Nation oral histories, the Great Spirit had caught and admired the beauty of the brook trout, and the Great Spirit's touch turned the black color of the trout into silvery spots and halos. Since the brook trout had been handled by the Great Spirit and spared for its beauty to live on, the Seneca Nation of Indians do not eat brook trout, but hold it as sacred in the highest regard of fish. Despite their relative small size now, before industrialized logging, many of the fish were in the 12 to 15 inch range, but the brook trout's health and future would be dramatically changed with the influx of European settlers in the 19th century. In the southern Appalachian region specifically, extensive logging of native forests occurred almost year round. With the forest canopy gone and streams heavily used for transporting logs, the waters became warmer and filled with silt. As a result, the brook trout population drastically declined, at one point nearing endangered status. In an effort to address this, officials introduced non-native species such as brown trout from Europe and rainbow trout from the American West, along with hatchery-raised brook trout. However, this approach backfired, as the interbreeding of native brook trout with hatchery-raised fish weakened the species' genetic integrity, and larger and more adaptable brown and rainbow trout outcompeted the native brook trout. Across their whole native range in America, their populations have dramatically declined due to habitat destruction, pollution, and competition with these non-native species, making hands-on conservation efforts essential for their survival. Today, conservationists are rewriting the narrative about these fish, implementing innovative solutions to restore this native species to its rightful place in the ecosystem. Over the years, we've been lucky enough to work with some amazing people and organizations who have been leading boots-on-the-ground conservation work in brook trout habitat. To name just a couple, the Alliance for the Chesapeake Bay and Trout Unlimited have been planting riparian forests and engaging in stream restoration to cool water temperatures and stabilize fish populations. By using both volunteers and corporate partnerships, these efforts have been a success by not just improving habitat, but by encouraging and inspiring community involvement. It is also essential for fisheries biologists to track data about these fish to see how their unique and complex ecosystems influence their health. Historically, there have been a few different methods to do this, including electrofishing, citizen science, and pit tagging, which can all be expensive, time-consuming, and invasive for the health of individual fish. That's why we were so excited to hear about a new program, harnessing the power of AI for the health and sustainability of the brook trout. We had to learn more, so we took a trip to West Virginia to talk to fisheries biologist Than Hitt at USGS.
Troutspotter is a program that puts the power of AI in the hands of anglers. And our hope is that it can transform the way we do fish biology. It can work anywhere, and it can really be a game changer because it gets anglers in the game in a new way. We've developed a computer vision model to learn the individual identity of these trout by their spot patterns. There's prior work out there already that shows how to identify species from images, and our work takes it to the next level by identifying individual fish based on their spot patterns. It turns out that those spots are really diagnostic. They're a thumbprint, essentially. So we can learn those individuals. And every time that fish is recaptured, caught again, you can get a notification on your phone saying, "We found him. George is okay. We saw him." And that's something we think is special because it'll give anglers a deeper sense of their connection to that resource. They know these places, they love these places, so they can deepen their understanding of these fisheries, while at the same time giving researchers a whole new opportunity for estimating abundance, survival, and movement, other things that we have to understand if we're going to conserve and manage these fisheries. This work is the product of many partners, including Trout Unlimited, Wild Me, and OnWater Fish, the app provider that anglers will use in the field to collect these images and submit them. And then USGS gets involved from a research perspective to make sense of this and to estimate abundance and to do things we care about for the management conservation side. These fish are basically the lifeblood of the mountains. They've been here for so long. They've been here through millennia. And I've got to say that, you know, working as a fish biologist on cold water fisheries in Appalachia is not all easy. I see with my own eyes some disturbing trends. So we have to do everything we can to conserve these habitats and these fishes because they are culturally important. Your grandparents fish for these fish. I want your grandkids to fish for these fish. And ecologically, they're super important because they are essentially our, you know, canary in the coal mine for climate change and for warming and for land use change. So we have to have these fish on the landscape for many reasons.
Tools like Troutspotter are pioneering the change in the brook trout narrative. Along with amazing AI tools that help to digitally measure fish and ID the unique species, this program will empower everyday anglers to make a real difference for our watersheds and coastal areas. As anglers who care deeply about our secret and sacred spots, it's also important to mention that the program won't contribute to spot burning. Every angler's success on the water remains private to their own in-app journal. While overdevelopment and technology have led us to where we are now, they are also providing solutions to where we can be in the future. Solutions that may aid in the increase of biodiversity, solutions that can help with the native brook trout, and solutions that we can take into our own hands. As silly as it sounds, Even taking the time out of your day to watch a video like this and to share it with your circle helps to spread the word, connecting people to a story in which they may not know even exists, which always seems to be the first step in sustainable change. We could all take inspiration from the resilient brook trout, because even here in the tamed East, there is hope and a distant promise of true redemption.